Hey everyone, welcome back to RJK English, and we're going to do the second part of the song Hallelujah. So the first part, we talked about Leonard Cohen's life, the background of making this song, and we talked a lot about the religious imagery that's part of this song, especially King David and his relationship with Bathsheba. We also talked a little bit about Samson, who also comes into the song. And how Leonard Cohen goes in and out of whether it's about Leonard Cohen or whether it's about David. But it's all about heartbreak. It's all about sin and personal failings and the unfairness of life, the pain of life. Let's start by looking at the form of the song itself. So it's dun, 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 four. One, two, three, four. But it also has a waltz feel to it. So unlike the other two songs which were in 4/4 time. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. This one has a different feel. It has a one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. And what is this? This is a waltz song like this. I heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Okay, so I heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. Okay, rhymes. But you don't really care for music, do ya? This is the rhyme scheme for the whole thing. These two match. These two match. Goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. Do ya, hallelujah. So you've got a rhyme, internal rhyme, a rhyme that goes, is split, internal rhyme, the end of the split. Let's see, your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. Hallelujah. She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne. She cut your hair. And from your lips, she drew the hallelujah. Now, Leonard Cohen wrote over 80 verses for this song. 80. Right now, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I think there's another one that I've heard. But he cut them down or the song when he finally was done with it. Let's see if it keeps going. Baby, I've been here before. I've seen this room, I've walked this floor. I knew ya. Arch, march, hallelujah. No, below, do ya. You, too, hallelujah. And then the final one is here. Let's see if it fits. Maybe there's a God above. Love. Outdrew ya, hallelujah, night light. Boom. So Leonard Cohen was a poet. So now we've talked about these verses. We're going to go on to the third. Baby, now we know he's talking to a woman. Okay, I sometimes call my wife baby, you know, and it's very common. There are themes of how North Americans talk to each other. And how we call the people we love baby. Baby, I've been here before. I've been here before doesn't always mean that I've been in this place before. It also means I've been in this situation before. So when a person is faced with being alone, when they've been in a relationship and now they're breaking up, they can sometimes turn to the person saying, I've been here before. I know what it's like to be alone, and I can do it again. I don't need you, right? Sometimes it's a threat. I've been here before. Or, you know, all of a sudden I'm poor again. I've been here before, right? Baby, I've been here before. I've seen this room, and I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew you. I've seen your flag on the marble arch, but love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a lonesome hallelujah. So I don't know what this means exactly. I've seen this room and I've walked this floor. But it kind of gives a feeling that Leonard Cohen sometimes in his songs gives the feeling of a monastery. A monastery where you live alone. He has a song like this. Sometimes I find myself thinking of the past when I swore to each other that our love were lost. So I choose the room that I live in with care. The windows are small and the walls are bare. There's only one question, there's only one prayer. And I wait every night for your step on the stair. Again, this monastery feel where it's just you alone. If you are following the book we're reading, Siddhartha, we talk about this, how Siddhartha becomes a monk and how you leave society and just become yourself individually. Well, he's pointing to kind of being a monk or like being a king, alone in your room. You're alone at the top, right? But he's saying, I've seen this room. I've walked this floor. I've been here before. I used to live alone before I knew you. I always need you. I've been alone before. And it's kind of sad, too. He used to live alone. He's had this relationship, and now he's going to be alone again. I've seen your flag on the marble arch, but love is not a victory march. I don't know exactly what flag on the marble arch means, except we've got this feel of a castle. And there's this flag that's, you know, showing that this lady is coming. There's a royal procession that's going to happen. But he's saying, you know, he's seen your flag on the marble arch. Maybe he's calling her a queen, you know, like, oh, queen, all high and mighty. I don't need you, you know. I've seen your flag on the marble arch. But love, real love, is not a victory march. What would usually come after that? It's real love is real feeling, but what does he say? It's a cold and it's a lonesome hallelujah. It's a cold and it's a lonesome hallelujah. A cold and lonesome give glory to God. You know, this is showing that the basis of life in this is lonesomeness. And this is the feeling you have when you're splitting with someone that you've loved or you're losing someone. Life is cold and lonesome. God wants us to glory him. Give glory to him. Okay, here we go. It's cold and lonesome. Hallelujah, God. You know, something like this. There was a time when you'd let me know what's really going on below. But now you never show it to me, do you? This is about the sexuality of a relationship. And when you've been intimate with someone, when you've been married or you've been in a relationship for a long time, you were together physically. Maybe you have children. Here it doesn't seem like we have children involved. But you used to be close. You used to share everything, even yourselves. And now you never show it to me. They don't have that relationship anymore. Remember when I moved in you? The holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew was hallelujah. Leonard Cohen's lyrics are always about sexuality and that bringing connectedness to God. That these are holy moments. This love is a holy moment. And this has a long history. The French and the royal, like King Arthur, all of that stuff in the history was about how sexual union was holy. And we even see this in Tantra in India and other things where this idea of, or even in Sufism, when you're, obviously they're talking about union with God, but they are using the analogy of the beloved, of missing the beloved and finally being unified with the beloved. And that implies a sexuality. And in our lives, this is important. We want someone that we can love physically and mentally and have that relationship. And right now he's saying, there's a time when you used to have that with me, and now you don't anymore. You never feel that way about me. Remember when I moved in you? Remember when we had those romantic times when the Holy Dove was moving? And the Holy Dove in Christianity is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit was moving in us. And every breath we drew was hallelujah. Look back at here when she tied him to the kitchen chair, broke his throne and cut his hair. And from his lips, she drew the hallelujah, like it's painfully pulled out, the hallelujah. There's a sexual and pain aspect to it. Every breath they drew was hallelujah, and they lost it. If you watched our last song, we talked about Aj Janikizid Nakaro. And at one point, they say, when you lose these fleeting moments, I hope you don't look back and miss it. I hope you don't look back and miss it, because you will. The moments of freedom are fleeting. The moments of real love can be fleeting, you know, especially when you're talking about sexuality. Okay, last one. Last line. Maybe there's a God above. This whole song says hallelujah, which means give glory to God, right? But maybe there's a God above. Only maybe. But all I ever learned from love is how to shoot at someone who outdrew you. What does it mean to outdraw? This is the idea, and in Cohen's songs, he has this idea of the cowboy. And probably he watched a lot of Westerns when he was young. And cowboys will face off against each other in a duel. And it's about who draws the gun first and who shoots first. The person who dies is the person who was outdrawn, because the other person drew first and shot. And he's saying how to shoot at somebody who outdrew you. So the other person got the best of him, but he still shoots. So there's a tragic feeling to this, right? Maybe there's a God above. He hasn't seen him. But all I ever learned from love, love and God are connected. Maybe there's a God above, but all I ever learned from love is how to shoot at someone who outdrew you. It's a contest. They end up shooting you, right? This is tragic. It's not, what is love? Love is not a cry that you hear at night. It could be a sexual cry, or it could be a cry of anguish over loss, or a cry that, oh, I wish my love was here, you know. It's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. This is a Christian idea of seeing the light, or also a Buddhist idea of enlightenment, of seeing the light, of being converted. So it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light, you know, this joy. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Love, in the end, according to Cohen, at least when he was writing this, love is a cold thing. It's not warm anymore. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. The end of love is to be broken. It's a very sad song, right? And yet it's so popular in the U.S. It's so popular in North America, and it's so popular worldwide now. Why? Because it's about loss of love. It's also about living with someone and them not understanding you. And any of us that have been through that and through the pain of that, we know this feeling when we feel like life is only about loss. And through these songs, maybe we know someone else feels that way and we can get through it. And then we move on to enjoying other things. But sometimes we have to feel this, right? So let's go ahead and listen to the song, and we'll follow along. We're going to listen to the Jeff Buckley version. I'm also going to put the Rufus Wainwright version in as well. Right? One moment. And this is quite a beautiful arrangement, too. In future songs where I can't really play the guitar to show the... I'm going to start with the video. I don't know how to switch to video. We'll just do video, and I'll be a little box on the side when we do more. But for now, just listen. Notice his guitar is almost like a bell. It's almost like he's playing piano, or there's a sacredness. At least from a Christian standpoint, we think of a cathedral. We'll hear this also if we ever do Where the Streets Have No Name by U2. They use this as well. Now he's getting into it.
there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you.
David and Bathsheba.
She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throat and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah. Walked this floor, you know. I used to live alone before I knew you. And I've seen your flag on the marble arch. And love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah.
So he says broken here.
Hallelujah.
We talk about being broken, and that's when our heart is broken and it feels like our life is broken. In Adjajani Kizila Nakaro, she says, Hum Mar Jayenge Hum To Lut Jayenge.
There was a time
I'll die, I'll be looted.
What's really going on below? But now you never show that to me. Remember when I moved in you, and the holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew was hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Maybe there is a God above. All I've ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody who I drew, yeah. It's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah.
The song of a broken person. They're not really just singing out praise. And yet there's a tradition in Judaism, especially from the idea of Job, who God took everything away from. And he complained to God, he cursed God. And that's a Jewish tradition as well.
Hallelujah!
So he's complaining against God. But that's acceptable because at least you're talking to God. He doesn't know if there's a God above, but he's still talking. So, I don't know. Does he believe in God or not? I don't know. And it's interesting that even from the brokenness of this, beauty comes. I mean, it's a song. Remember at the beginning, David played and it pleased the Lord. It has to, right? Because it's beautiful. It touches all of us. We're all part of this experience. And we feel it, right? So, I hope you enjoyed that. I really enjoyed teaching this. The song meant a lot to me, especially at one point in my life. Make sure if you like these videos, like and subscribe. It really will help me to keep creating videos. I'm a small operation, just getting up and going. If you are looking for English lessons, you can contact me. We don't just go through songs, go through a lot of different things. Check out our page. I have videos on English grammar that I'm continuing. I'm continuing to complete that. Please share this with someone else who might like it. And comment. Let's talk about this. What do you think of this? Do you agree with Cohen? Do you like it? Do you like it? Just talk to me about it. And then hit me up on RJK English and we can talk even further, okay? All right. See you later.